Hi, I'm Landon with Spartan Controls, and today I'm going to show you how to mount a Fisher 667i Actuator onto a Fisher sliding stem valve. Like all procedures, we should start out by making sure we're wearing proper personal protective equipment for the job at hand. Before we begin, make sure you verify the bench head of your actuator. If you're not sure how to do this, check for a link in the description below for a video on how to do that. Next, prepare your valve by removing your yoke lock nut. And installing your stem nuts. With the valve prepared, our next step will be to prepare the actuator. We'll do that by removing our stem connecting block and installing our valve's nameplate. With the actuator now prepared, I'll apply a 35 psi regulated air supply to my actuator, moving it to the upper travel stop, and then I will lift and lower my actuator onto my valve assembly. Before I lower my actuator all the way, I'll install my yoke lock nut and indicator disc. Now I can lower my actuator the rest of the way and then tighten down my yoke lock nut. With that snugged up, I will now line my actuator up with the valve and tighten the yoke lock nut down using a hammer and flat chisel. Next, we're going to verify that our valve is in its fully seated position. To do that, I'll pry up on my valve stem and then fully seat the valve. If you find it difficult to move the valve stem, feel free to loosen your packing nuts. With the valve fully seated, I can now line up my indicator disc with my travel scales fully closed position. And then pry up on my valve stem, moving the valve to its full rated travel position. With the valve at its full travel, I'll move my stem nuts out of the way and install my connecting block. And with the connecting block tightened, I will now tighten my stem nuts up to my indicator disc and tighten them tight against my connecting block. Lastly, I will adjust my travel scale to match up with the fully open position. The only thing left to do at this point is to remove our actuator's air supply and verify that the actuator scopes the correct distance. And that concludes our overview on how to mount a Fisher 667i actuator onto a Fisher sliding stem valve. Thanks for watching.